Dear students, in this video, I will make you understand how Spirogyra reproduces by means of a vegetative method. So keep watching on this video. When the environmental conditions becomes exceptionally more favorable, in such condition, Spirogyra it multiplies by means of vegetative method, and this method is more commonly a fragmentation. The fragmentation it can take place by the dissociation of the filament at the cross wall area into more short length, or it sometimes in the form of segments, and therefore such a segment formation is referred as a fragmentation in case of a Spirogyra. Each fragment it may consist of new living cells or even a single cell also. This single cell or certain fragments or segments can grow into a new filament by a repetitive cell division method, and consequently growth takes place, it gives rise to a new filament. Thus, it is very interesting to know us how fragmentation is brought about, and we can study it with reference to following different ways. So vegetative reproduction, which is generally a fragmentation type, it can be takes place by a mechanical injury or sometimes by some other methods also. So when we talk about the mechanical injury, it is caused by the bite of a fish or some other aquatic animals, or actions of water currents also. Even this takes place by means of a softening and subsequent dissolution of the middle lamella of the end walls, which is present between two cells of a filament. In fact, by sudden changes in the habitat, there are certain factors such as the temperatures or acidity of a water. This middle lamella of a end wall, it becomes little bit mucilaginous and jelly-like substance, or it becomes gelatinous. Subsequently, as a turgor pressure increases or differences has been get arised between the adjacent cells, or in fact a gelatinous substance, it leads to causing one cell to get bulged into the another one. So this pressure, it leads to bulging to the another cells, is that a cellular component, and in this way the strain or pressure on the junction between the cell, it finally reaches toward the breaking point. And ultimately what happened, this filament's septum at the middle portion, it starts to get break, and forcibly it starts to get separate apart. So this mechanism is generally called as a cell disjunction. So the breaking the filament's septum is referred as a cell disjunction mechanism. There are certain species in which the middle lamella, which is present over there, as you can see here in the photograph, this middle septum, it is get affected over there. So subsequent dissolution of a middle lamella, it is always cause of a disjunction over there. There are certain species in which end walls, they may be having various use that a configuration, as you have seen in earlier studies over there, different types of cross walls or septums are there. Just like as here in this particular diagram, you will find it out that this species of a Spirogyra is possessing the replicate type of a wall over here. In fact, in case of this diagram D over there, the ring of one cell, it get evaginated and forcing apart the cell. In certain cases, the rings of the other cell get of course evaginated after separation to get a distinct rounded extremities over there, as you can see in case of a E and F photograph over here. There are some species, they develop edge-shaped pieces. For example, a Spirogyra colligata, this is the species in which colligate septum or edge-shaped septa are existing over there. So in these cases, the end wall of a adjacent cell, as you can see in the diagram G, that is possessing the colligate form of a septum over there, or edge septum is there. So this makes the fragment very relatively in simple way of a separation, or you can call it as a fragmentation. So this is the one of the simplest way. The diagram what you can see here, the GH, that shows the simple form of a separation. And in this way, the wall is inward owing to increased turgor pressure on the cells, and of course H shaped pieces, they slips off from this entire filament, and consequently two cells are get separated from each other. So this is the nothing but a fragmentation, or you say that is creating the segments over there. In this way fragmentation it is carried out. So there are various pieces, there are different examples are there, but as a part of a basic knowledge or understanding, you can just simply focus on this particular aspect of a fragmentation. I hope that you have understood this particular mechanism, how the mechanical injury or the softening and dissolution of the middle lamella, it is causing the fragmentation, and followed by that individual cell it divides, redivides and makes a new filament. I'll try to show you one example, replicate of septa, how it is there, and it causes you see that a fragmentation over there. So in cell disjunction, only with one example I'll try to illustrate here. You can see here, these are the replicate form of a end walls over there, and such replicate form of a end wall, you can see here, this at these particular areas or region, these are the replicate end walls are there, and these end walls, they get protruded interior to the adjacent cell, and causing the increased turgor pressure leads to breaking the septum, and in this way the cells are get separated out. So my dear students, I hope that you have understood this particular concept of a vegetative reproduction by means of a fragmentation. So keep watching the further series of the videos, where you will come to know about another mode of a reproduction in Spirogyra. So thank you very much for watching this video.